Well, last fall, Troy and I went to Okoboji Bible Conference for the first time ever. And just during the whole thing, just worship and praise. And one of the gals came up and she was just sharing an event that she had done at her own school in Sheldon, Iowa. And it was a prom pampering event. And so that's where I got the idea of just having this event to do hair, nails, makeup for the area schoolgirls that were going to go to prom. So I kind of shared the idea with people in my small group, and they thought it was a really good idea. And then youth group leaders, they thought it would be a great idea. So what I did was I approached Valita, who works at the high school, and I said, "What do you think about this?" And her first response was, "Love it."
So we were at a community group Bible study, and it was sometime in March, and Mickey had mentioned that she had a friend who put together a prom pampering event. Last year, I think it was, and it had gone really well. And she asked me what I thought about putting a prom pampering event free for girls to come get hair, makeup, nails done the day of prom and offer it just as a service event. And I thought it sounded awesome, especially because a lot of our girls don't have the money to do something like that, and a lot of our girls do. And so I think there's a real maybe intimidating feeling about showing up at prom when you did your hair and your makeup in your bathroom, or maybe your sister did it and somebody else has gone and gotten $300 worth of pampering and they show up at prom in this gorgeous dress and you're maybe feeling a little underdone. And for girls to be able to come and get loved on and pampered and get that dream hair makeup done free across the street from the location, I just thought this sounded like an awesome idea and a great way to love on some girls that maybe wouldn't be getting that otherwise. So we had a huge response from school, and then once we started advertising, and especially once I think the paper, the Tribune called and asked if they could do a little article on it, then we started getting girls sending emails or moms emailing, "You don't know what a blessing this is. I have 5 daughters, and to be able to have my daughter go get this done free is an incredible blessing." So it really took off once it was advertised.
Valita, her daughter, she does a makeup called Senegence, which is a really good high quality makeup that lasts a long time. So she was going to bring that and donate a lot. And then Valita, she ordered some extra stuff that we'd need. We had gals that volunteered brushes and combs and curling irons. These girls you could just tell that when they walked in the door, they were really kind of uncomfortable, but I think that they just could feel that we loved them and we cared. And so they just relaxed and they weren't afraid to say, "I want this." And we just tried to do our best to make them feel like they were gonna be ready for prom.
I invited my friends and they didn't, they were super wary at first. And then they were telling me about how they wanted their parents to do their makeup, or how they were gonna go to a professional get their hair done. And I went at them a whole bunch about it, and I was like, "I really want you to come with me." I just kept inviting them. So they eventually came, and when my friend walked in, she saw the lady doing the makeup, and she saw how she did it and how good the makeup was, and she immediately just stopped, and she was like, "She's doing my makeup. I'm not going to my mom. She's not doing my hair. She's doing my makeup." And I was like, "Okay. This is good." And then when we were doing the hair, I did my friend's hair. And at the end, my mom was finishing curling it. And my friend goes, "You know, I'm so happy I came here instead of did it at home, because I had more fun here than I did at home, what I would have had at home." And I was like, "I think that's a good thing."
So I think one of the funnest things about it was, as the girls came in really giddy excited, they were showing the pictures of what they wanted their hair and makeup to look like. Once they started to get their little prom pampering makeover, their excitement, and as more girls were in the room and adults were pampering them, they would look at each other and say, "Oh my gosh, your hair looks amazing," and "Ooh, I love your makeup." And they just felt special and loved on, and that was really what we wanted. But then I think what really topped it off for me was one of a student that I had last year. She came in, she was a little shy about coming in. Her mom actually also came in, and we did her mom's nails while she was getting pampered. That was kind of fun. She was sitting in the chair and she had her toes out and her fingers had already gotten done. She was waiting in line for her makeup, and as her toes were getting done, she sat in her chair and she said, "Oh my gosh, I feel like a queen." And that was really, I think, how a lot of the girls felt, and that's what we wanted. We wanted them to feel like queens when they walked out. And I think too, one of the things I really appreciated was afterward, It wasn't just fun that day, but girls were coming into my room that Monday and showing me pictures. You want to see what my dress looked like with my hair and makeup? And do you want to see what my group looked like? And we still got to carry on that conversation. I still got to love on them a little bit afterward, tell them how gorgeous they looked and find out about their night and just develop that relationship a little bit further that we had started at the pampering. But now, you know, we can continue throughout the week. And when I see them in the hall, I know them a little bit better and can just give them a little extra attention and you know, personalize our conversation throughout the day because we spent some time together before prom.